All right, so a little closer look here on the battle. So just recapping what I did, right? Unscrew this screw here. This guy comes out. Let me see, there's a little shade coming on. Yeah, so this guy comes out. This guy's on the side, the screws here. Come out, you unscrew this. So once you unscrew this guy, these two, you take this off, just pull it off, and this plastic thing with all these connections comes out, and just the socket stays. And then the PCB that comes out, this green stuff right here where the component's sitting. So just for the information, I know some of you know what I'm, you know, all the stuff I'm talking about, probably much more than I do, but some people are just like me, just started, don't know anything, and are trying to learn it. And sometimes I find it better to learn from a guy who just learned and probably gonna talk my language than learning from somebody who's gonna throw a bunch of specific languages and I mean expressions and names and stuff like that. It's just gonna keep me confused instead of going straight to the point. So going straight to the point, unscrew this guy, and this guy. This comes out. I won't pull it out. I'll just mash it in some footage I did earlier to show what goes on behind this guy, because you have to basically get the top connection of this guy. Let's say this is the bottom, this is the top. So this connection on the other side, what I did was I soldered this wire into this capacitor over here. So this wire came straight to this connection here up top, right here. So the problem I was having is because most people do this with the LED mod, and they use the 9 plug 1, whatever that switch called, the 3DP whatever, and there's tons of diagrams online. So my mistake was I had this all wired right, but my mistake was the double blue cable, which is not this one. This one is the connection I made, right? So which is this blue cable that comes from here and the blue cable that comes from here, they're together, and I was soldering them to the bottom right guy here, and they're supposed to be here on the top left. So I had this guy over here as a jump wire from this side to this side, and that was my mistake, because when I did that, it would work only either cling or wah-wah effect, and whenever I pressed the button, it would stop working, would just be boo. And I thought would the problem was between the purple and the connection I did to the capacitor, and I kept switching these guys, and that's when I figured out, okay, one of these guys control clean or wow or whatever, and there's one connection I'm missing to get the other side of the equation. So I came across this guy's diagram, and it was the connection of the jumper from this guy on the bottom with the green one over here. And as soon as I plugged this blue guy here, which is the jumper cable from this bottom one here together with the green one on the top right, rubber hit the road, and I switch this too. I unscrew this and I move this thing to the side, and I turn the wheel a little bit in a way that I'm going more, I'll have more mid range than it would have on the stock standard way that it came from the factory. So just because I like a little more mid range on my sound. Eventually I will, once I get a decent drilled enclosure here, and I'll put an LED light, and it comes with the connections with these guys over here, which I'm not gonna get right now. And yeah, so right now I'm gonna record the sound of this working, so everybody can see that finally worked after a bunch of hours. So sit this guy down here, a beautiful guitar, and now it's time to rock. Which I can't rock anyway, because I suck. So yeah, this is the sound without without the effect on, obviously. Now I'm gonna kick in the wah pedal. I'm